I'm Dr. Clifford Courville. I'm a pulmonologist at Lake Charles Memorial Hospital. Right now, what we're seeing with COVID pneumonia patients, we're seeing a plateau in the number of new cases, and there is a trend and perhaps a decrease in the number of new cases that we're seeing each day. This means that we might be in the what we call the early recovery phase of this outbreak in the area, which puts us in a good position. We still do have cases. We still do have people that are very, very sick in the hospital. As of right now, there are about 6 people in the ICU right now with COVID pneumonia. But what we're seeing is a reduction in the number of new patients that are coming to the hospital, which again puts us in a good position. Because we've been able to flatten out this curve and reduce the number of new cases coming each day, it has bought us time to look into new treatments. One of those new treatments or potential new treatments is something called convalescent plasma. Essentially, we obtain plasma or blood product from a patient who has recovered from the illness, and we transfuse that product into a patient who is still struggling. It takes time to develop antibodies to a virus, and therefore it has taken about 4 to 6 weeks from the first case in the community for us to find those patients who have recovered, obtain their plasma, and then be able to transfuse it to the patients who are still struggling. We have access to that as part of a program in conjunction with the Mayo Clinic. We know other hospitals in town likewise are participating in the same program. And this is information and treatment protocol that we are sharing and really trying to give patients access to every possible new therapy available. We don't know if it's working just yet. It's too early to tell. This is why we're doing this as part of a study trial, so we can see, given to large numbers of people, if it makes an impact. I can say that the patients I have given the plasma to, they are still hanging in there. In other words, their disease has stabilized, and I think it provided them a valuable tool to help their recovery. They have been studying multiple antiviral therapies out there. These antiviral therapies are not available to the community hospitals. They are only available as part of a clinical trial. And one of those drugs, which has made a lot of progress, is something called remdesivir. It is an antiviral. It is a drug that attacks the virus itself. And it's too early again to know how it impacts survival in this illness, but the preliminary data does seem to indicate that it perhaps shortens the duration of the illness and perhaps the severity. And it will be a valuable tool going forward as we begin to reopen and new cases appear. If at that moment we have a tool that can shorten the severity or the duration, we could mitigate the severity of any future outbreaks. Its impact would be similar to what we see with Tamiflu, which is also an antiviral which targets influenza. It's not a drug that cured influenza per se, but it did shorten the duration of the illness, which helps to reduce the amount of spread and perhaps the amount of may help reduce the number of patients that could get sick from it. And therefore, this new antiviral would be a very useful tool. We are reaching out to others in the community, and there will be a concerted effort to try and obtain this drug, not just for our hospital, but for all the hospitals in the community. They're trying to shorten the trials. Essentially, if a drug has shown benefit, it allows them to ethically reduce the length of the trial. They don't have to carry it out for an additional year or two. They can begin giving it to all patients sooner. I feel we are in a good position. Our community has done great with social distancing. We have seen a plateau. We have seen even a reduction in the number of new cases, but people still need to be cautious. The virus is still there. You could still catch it from somebody who may not know they have symptoms. We still have sick people in the hospital. The numbers aren't as high, and we have resources to treat them, but people still need to be cautious. We need to continue to keep this curve flat until these new therapies are more readily available, and definitely until the virus seems to be on a downward trend in terms of incidence.